I got sick with the flu, and it just kept getting worse every day for about a week. I went to the doctor. They didn't know what it was, but they got some chest x-rays from me, and I went home, was taking medicine. That Saturday, I couldn't breathe anymore, so I went back to the doctor. They thought it was bronchitis and put me on an inhaler. The next day, I felt like I was dying, so my parents took me to the emergency room. I was immediately transferred up to the intensive care unit because they knew how bad off I was. I watched the Super Bowl with my dad that night. I was woken up by a nurse who was prompting me to breathe more. And I told that nurse I cannot breathe any more than I am right now.
My wife said, you know, you're probably not going to get him out that day. But instead, I found him on a ventilator, totally unconscious. And she told me that if we don't get him on ECMO, there's nothing more they can do for him and he'll die. You have your choice. You can go to Hershey, you can go to Pittsburgh, or you can go to Maryland. I said, well, Hershey's the closest, because they told me time was of the essence. Come back the next morning. We find out it's too windy for the helicopter to land at Chester County Hospital, so it landed at a little airport not too far away. So they loaded him into an ambulance to take him over there. We watched them load him into the helicopter, and it was really windy. The blades of the helicopter were almost touching the ground. We saw him get strapped in, and the helicopter took off, and we beat down the turnpike, and we were almost to the exit, to the Hershey exit on the turnpike, when the chief surgeon on the helicopter team called us and said he was safely in bed in the ICU here at Hershey Medical Center, and that, you know, we could arrive. As soon as we got there, we were ushered into a room where Dr. Bonnie asked, he said, I need to do this. This could take his life. You need to do this. This could take his life. You need to do this. It could take his life. And we said, yes. What choice do we have? So we signed immediately, and then 2 hours later he was on ECMO. So that was how we got to here. When we got there, we went in and he said hi, and I realized the ventilator was out. We didn't even know that they were going to be taking it out. So that was a pretty good weekend. Dr. Boniassi and the staff at Hershey Medical Center are tremendous, because we called in the middle of the night. We couldn't sleep, so we called the nurses, and they'd talk to us. They recognized my wife's voice. She called them.
But I was glad to be alive, and it you know, the depression didn't last long, because eventually I realized, you know, this is a chance for me to do things a little different. Just was happy to see everybody again. So my kidneys are back. As soon as I got off dialysis, I started going to the gym and just gained health rapidly. My lungs will always have scars, but I can make up for that by living an active lifestyle, and the remaining functional lung tissue should be able to compensate for the scar tissue.
Without that ECMO, though, I wouldn't have him here today.